government has decided to support the Supreme Court judgment through this bill, and this is an admirable cause. The Honorable Law Minister has pointed out that more than 200 cases have come even after the Supreme Court's judgment, which is really alarming. Even after the Supreme Court says, passes a law, then it should not happen. The idea is to remove an old age practice of some Indian Muslim men and provide relief and justice to Indian Muslim women from a constant threat of instant divorce through triple pronouncement. So the bill has undergone a few changes over the past few iterations, sorry ma'am, and in its present form seeks to deter Muslim husbands from whimsically divorcing their wives. If passed, the bill shall provide the equality to women that the Constitution mandates and the Honorable Supreme Court recommends. Ma'am, no other country, as correct me wherever I'm wrong and if I'm wrong, no other country having a majority population of Muslims has such law now. But why India? It's not in Pakistan, not in Bangladesh, not in Indonesia, not in Iraq, not in Iran, nowhere. Then why are we so far behind? So my stance and my party's stance on this bill is, we are in complete agreement with the government as far as the letter and intent of the bill stands. But now I wish to point out certain issues that should be addressed in the bill. And I request Honorable Minister to kindly consider these certain issues from our side, certain suggestions from our side. So my first issue is, as previously highlighted by my respected senior and a former member of this August House, esteemed Sri Tathagat Satpathy Ji, while he was speaking on this bill in the 16th Lok Sabha, even Mr. Bhartari Mahtab Ji had spoken and moved five amendments on this. I am happy and glad to say that the government has almost accepted all the amendments. Just one or two are still our suggestions from you, sir. So the Tathagat Babu had said, the triple talaq bill criminalizes a civil wrong done by a particular community. As marriage itself is a civil contract, we feel that divorce-related offenses under it should not be criminalized unless it can be linked to domestic violence or other criminal law issues. So since the bill proposes that the act of triple talaq will result in imprisonment up to 3 years for the husband, there is no clear provision as to how the incarcerated person will provide maintenance to the wife. Sir, ma'am, they are generally poor people, either rickshaw pullers, working in hotels, or they depend on daily wages. They work every day, they earn every day, and they feed themselves every day. So if a person, a poor person, is sent to jail, how is it possible for him to pay maintenance to his wife? It is really complicated, and it has to be cleared by the government. Also, as a triple talaq is void and the divorce would not have taken place, an incarcerated man may be coerced to provide a maintenance subsistence allowance to a woman who is still his wife legally. Ma'am, when we are saying it is illegal, triple talaq is illegal and void by the Supreme Court law, then how is it possible that when the man is in jail and he will have to pay the maintenance to his legally wedded wife? So we have to think on it also. The triple talaq bill should include a provision giving the woman the option to ratify marriage annulment and claim the maintenance under this bill. Ma'am, the wife has to be empowered and given a choice to elect whether she wants criminal consequences or civil consequences. Ma'am, let her take the decision, let her take the power to elect which one she opts to. And ma'am, moreover, society is today moving towards decriminalizing and interpersonal relationships. 377 has been decriminalized, adultery has been. So let's think a little broader and beyond party lines, beyond political agendas. If we can think on it and consider it in more wider space, wider way, it will be more helpful for the Indian Muslim women. And of course, it will be an honor from our side to the women and empower them to move forward. Ma'am, I'll just conclude in some more time. Yes, ma'am. I would like to say, declaring the practice of triple talaq as void and illegal and providing for punishment as well as subsistence acts as a sufficient deterrent to potential perpetrators of instant divorce and will go a long way in empowering Muslim women in this country. I am very happy today that I have been given an opportunity to speak on this wonderful historical bill, and I'm a part of this historical debate. I'm really blessed, privileged. For this, I would like to thank my party, Biju Janata Dal, my leader Naveen Babu, and of course you, ma'am, for giving me this opportunity. I believe the government will definitely accept my suggestions and kindly address during his reply on this bill. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.